Never do business with your friends. Never build a startup without a technical founder. Never go to market without a minimum viable product. Never go to a VC without a well-thought-out pitch deck. And never, ever hire people from Craigslist. From breaking all these rules and more, my next guest, serial entrepreneur and now investor Jack Smith, somehow turned a terrible idea into a $780 million exit. Originally from England, Jack moved to San Francisco in 2011 as part of an audacious LinkedIn hack to enter the incubator AngelPad. Jack co-founded mobile ad startup Vungle, a Google Ventures-funded startup with millions of revenue which was eventually acquired for $780 million by Blackstone. Post-Vungle, Jack started advising startups like Cerveos, RCI, and OnFleet, many of these worth over $100 million with exits to back, all before the age of 30. Today, we unpack scaling a startup, the hard lessons along the way from co-founder breakups to investor scandals, the good, bad, and ugly. You don't want to miss.
And then as a company grows, I think you need to kind of fire yourself from those different responsibilities and scale yourself into a different role where you're not all about doing, you're more about like enabling. And what I observed there was that Zane just somehow naturally really scaled really, really fast for him himself into this role of being a CEO, like a professional CEO. Like he just like naturally took on that and the transition was very natural for him. Whereas for me, I was kind of just still stuck in the weeds and I think actually was slowing the business down a lot because I was a bottleneck that I hadn't been successful in firing myself. So even if it was like a tiny, I think we also had a challenge growing our mindset from a scarcity mindset to a growth mindset. We were used to having no money. We wouldn't spend any money, but then raising 2 million, you need to transition that. But still, even when I was there towards the end, I was signing like $20 checks and stuff. And that's not conducive to scaling a business. So I think I was kind of slowing it down. So that was one reason that I didn't scale my bit as much because I was stuck in the business too much. And my co-founder seemed to scale a lot better. And the other bit was quite burnout as well, that I basically had got an apartment opposite our office. So it was literally across the street. And so basically I didn't really have any friends in San Francisco either. I didn't know anyone. I basically was just in the office 7 days a week, all of the time. And I was there till after midnight each day, like much longer than everyone else left, because I just didn't really have a life outside of it. Yeah. And so that also does catch up on you, where if you don't have any separation, that if you just only work, then kind of just you are going to burn out at some point.